In this solved example, we will take a look at how to calculate the CVA, the credit valuation adjustment, for a very simple position. And this position is in a risky corporate bond. We are given that a 3-year corporate bond pays a coupon of 8% per annum. This coupon is paid once a year. The term structure of risk-free interest rates is given to be flat at 4% per annum. Let's assume that this interest rate is annually compounded. And we are also given that interest rates are expected to stay unchanged in the future. So in the future also, our interest rate term structure will stay flat at 4% per annum. If the risk-neutral conditional probability of default of the issuer of this corporate bond is given to be 2% for a 1-year period, and the recovery rate in the event of default is given to be 40%, assumed to be constant over the life of this bond, the task at hand is to compute the credit spread of this corporate bond. Let's start by computing the risky value of this corporate bond. That means the value of this corporate bond, assuming that it indeed is a risky bond, it can default, and also the risk-free value of this corporate bond. That means assuming that the issuer will not default. Very quickly, recall this, that the risky value of this corporate bond can be written as its risk-free value minus CVA, the credit valuation adjustment. Recall quickly the formula of CVA. I have written down the formula here. Essentially, it is loss given default that times the sum of expected exposure times the marginal probability of default times discount factor. This product summed over the number of time intervals that you have subdivided your entire horizon into. So for this particular case, our horizon is 3 years, the life of this corporate bond, and we will assume that we will be subdividing this entire horizon into these many time intervals. What you can also do is that you can multiply the expected exposure with the discount factor and write the product of these two to be the discounted expected exposure. Okay, so let's quickly draw the cash flow diagram of this simple instrument, this corporate bond. Let me assume that the face value that I'll be working with is $100. So after 1 year, I get a coupon of $8. After 2 years, another coupon of $8. Finally, at the maturity of the bond, I get the remaining $8 coupon and the principal of $100. Let me assume that for this CVA calculation, I will subdivide this entire 3-year horizon into three intervals, three time intervals, okay? One each corresponding to the 3 years of the life of this corporate bond. So now let's do this. For each of these three sub intervals, these time intervals, let's compute the inputs that go into this CVA formula. Okay, let's begin by calculating the expected exposure first. So since we are assuming that interest rates don't really change during the life of this corporate bond, it makes our lives quite easy. If I were to place myself at any point in time in the future, because there is no variability of interest rates that I need to worry about, the future value of this corporate bond, assuming there is no default, can be easily computed. Okay, so if I were to place myself at this T equal to 1 year time point, just before this corporate bond pays out its promised coupon of $8, the risk-free value of this corporate bond is simply the discounted value of all these future cash flows, and that's what I have computed here. Okay, discounting is being done at the risk-free rate of interest of 4%. So this gives me the future value of this corporate bond at this time point to be 115.5444. The exposure is max of 0, this guy. So exposure is also 115.5444. Since there is no variability associated with this future value, or for that matter, this exposure, the expected exposure also equals this same amount. Okay? Repeat the same exercise by now placing yourself just before, you know, this second coupon is paid out. And you can quickly check that the expected exposure for this second time period is 111.8462. Finally, for the third time period, the expected exposure is this total amount which this bond has to pay out, and that is $108. Okay, now let's move on to determining the marginal probability of default input to the CVA formula. For the first period, the marginal probability of default PD1 actually equals the conditional probability of default, which has been given to us, and that is 2%. For the second period, the marginal probability of default will simply be equal to the survival probability for the first period, which is 1 minus 2%, that times the conditional probability of default during the second period, and that is 2%. Okay, so this gets me to the marginal probability of default for the second period, and that is 1.96%. Okay, similarly, going with the same logic, the marginal probability of default for the third period comes out to survival probability for period 1 times survival probability for period 2, that times the conditional default probability for the third period. So this tells me that PD3 is 1.92%. Okay, so the only inputs which are left to be determined are discount factors. Simple, just use the 4% per annum annually compounded interest rate, compute DF1, DF2 and DF3, and what's remaining to be computed is loss given default. And that is 1 minus the recovery rate. Recovery rate is 0.4, so LGD comes out to 0.6. At this stage, please note that usually when it comes to bonds, recovery rate is expressed as a percentage of face value of the bond. But just to keep things consistent with the formulas that we have been using in the curriculum, we'll be assuming that the recovery rate which is given to us is measured as a percentage of the prevailing exposure of the instrument. Okay, so we have all the inputs required. Just plug in all these inputs into the CVA formula and quickly check that your CVA, it comes to 3.6554. Okay, very quickly determine the risk-free value of the bond. These are the TVM inputs required for the purpose. This is your risk-free value. This minus CVA gives you the risky value. So this is your risky value. Again, using your TVM functionality in your calculator, convert this risky value into an equivalent yield number. You will check that the yield comes out to 5.2503%. So 5.2503% minus the risk-free 4% tells you that the credit spread is approximately 125 basis points. So this solved example was about quickly understanding how to compute the CVA of any given instrument. In this video, it was a very simple instrument, a risky corporate bond, and to use the CVA to arrive at the risky valuation of this instrument.